Canyoner here in Taiwan gave us these homemade swage cables to brake test.
When I say swaged, I use the term loosely and that the sleeves were hammered down as opposed to using some swaging pliers.
They were to be installed with some smaller wedge bolts like these 8mm ones that go into these holes here.
The plan was to use a combination of nuts and washers to elevate it off the rock.
We've tested a lot of wedge bolts already, so I'm mostly kind of curious about these, so we're going to pull them end to end.
They use 4mm wire rope.
In the samples I received, the cable, the thimble, and this plate here are stainless steel, while the sleeve is aluminum and this is galvanized.
Here's sample number one.
The little hanger plate broke.
10 kilonewtons.
Broke here.
About 15 kilonewtons.
This is sample number two. Little hanger plate broke.
9.58 kN.
Cable end broke.
11.02.
Sample number three. Pulled out of the sleeve.
Got 9 kilonewtons.
This is sample number four. Pulled out of the sleeve.
10.44.
So in all our tests, everything broke above 9 kilonewtons. What impressed me were these little anchor plates that are about 1/16 of an inch thick. A lot of strength for these little things. So one concern of mine is how the swaging was done. You know, with this sleeve hammered down, there's not really any sort of guide or chart that I know of that can tell you this after swage measurements. However, if proper swaging tools were used, there are charts out there that you can check the after swage measurements, either with a pair of calipers, or you can just go get a gauge and slide that on to check. What was also interesting was how putting on this additional sleeve on the free ends added an additional 5 kilonewtons for this cable that's rated to about 9 or 10 by itself.